The Feast of Saint Rose of Viterbo. Today we celebrate the Feast of Saint Rose of Viterbo. She was born of poor parents, but they were devout, fervent Catholics, loyal to the Pope. She was known when she was growing up as a young child of 7 years of age. She was known to be an extraordinary person of penance and prayer, and she encouraged fellow citizens of Viterbo to be loyal to the Church and defend the Pope. When she was 15 years old, she wanted to join the poor clergy, but because she was not able to provide for the required dowry, she was rejected. That time she foretold that when she is dead, she would not need a dowry to enter the poor clergy. Later on, she joined the Franciscans of Third Order and received its habit and cord. Later, the Holy Roman Emperor Frederick II captured Viterbo and abused the Church and spoke ill of the Pope. And Rose defended the Pope and wanted the Catholics to be loyal to the Church. Later she foretold that the Emperor would quickly die, and in a few days' time the Emperor died on the 13th of December 1251. Rose also died within a few months out of a severe congenital heart problem. A few centuries later, in fact 4 centuries later, the city of Viterbo underwent a severe pestilence, and the people flocked to her for her intercession, and they were saved. In gratitude for the favor they received, every year, even now, on the eve of her feast, that is on the 3rd of September every year, they take out a procession with her statue on a high tower, decorated, illuminated with 3,000 tiny electric bulbs and hundreds of candles. Her example of defending the Church and praying for the people and doing penance for the reparation of sinners is relevant in our own time. Presently, the Church needs more and more people to defend it by actively living our faith.